Study of pattern in which temperature and humidity is controlled in the buildings designed by architect Baker. So as you all know, Laurie Baker was one of the finest architects who performed vernacular architecture, low-cost architecture. Let's study a bit of his philosophy which drived him to get in the perfect comfort levels in his buildings. So indigenous architecture, avoiding all the unnecessary items, respecting nature, non-degradation of site, using earthy materials were his important points of his philosophy. And the basic challenge that we face today are ventilation and heat gain. So what is a comfort zone and how to derive it? This is what we are going to study further. So basically, humidity and temperature has an indirect relation, as you see in this graph. And we are basically studying his buildings in the climate of Kerala, which is primarily hot and humid. So 6 case studies I had performed as a part of my research, out of which 5 were the vernacular pieces that he had designed, and the last one was a conventional building, in order to compare. The methodology that I used was with the use of hygrometers. Basically, they have a wet bulb and a dry bulb. I had used 6 of these hygrometers, out of which 4 were kept inside the building and 2 outside, and I used to record the readings of these meters. The other way, qualitative analysis of his buildings, was through observing the site condition, the design, the material specification, the windows, openings, semi-open areas, color, texture, pattern, and the dry bulb and the wet bulb readings. So one of the project which I'll talk in detail is this, which is architect Sargent's residence, designed on his principles. As you see the material palette, it is pretty much clear, which is vernacular. Now the southwest star is the highest, which shades the northeastern part of the house, and there is a continuous stack effect that happens in the central block. There is a semi-open gazebo from where you approach towards the eastern side, which helps render a microclimate. So this is the northeast portion, which has no walls. It's completely open and it is shaded by the southwest taller tower. So these were pretty much the readings of 12 hours that I had taken, and I realized that as you go from the basement to the taller side of the room, the temperature increases. And thus the dry bulb temperature had a peculiar difference of 2 degrees Celsius when you measure it. So when you compare these readings with the boys' hostel, which was a conventional building, there was a drastic difference in the temperature and the humidity level. Now how this is achieved, we'll see. Some of the important aspects are the openings and window assemblies. Like, you know, most of the openings are very infiltrated. The material specification was very vernacular and very breathable. The technologies that were applied, like the filler slab and rat trap bond and jali facades, were one of the primary points in architecture which led to this kind of comfort levels. Then there were a few other case studies, like the project called as Hamlet. It was very organic in design, spatial design. There were ponds, there were interconnection between the inside and the outside, which led to comfort levels again in the temperature, as you see the graph. And so did the humidity. The other project of his was the Laurie Baker Center, which was divided on vast land. And there were circular plannings, which led to evaporative cooling. There were curved roofs, because of which there was no direct sunlight hitting the roof, which made it cooler. The other project was across the lake, and design was split along a central spine. So you see water channels, you see different home gardens along, and these were the basic features that made that place very comfortable. So there was stable temperature and humidity observed even in this project. The 5th case study was the Center of Development Studies, which had circular plan forms, because of which the perimeter by area ratio was very less. And due to the jalis and the window assemblies, again the same result was derived, that the inside temperature was pretty much controlled. So through the comparative analysis of Baker's building and conventional buildings, we realized the circular plan forms led to very less surface to volume ratio. The openings were large. Roofing systems were pitched, because of which the sun rays were not direct. And all of these pointers led to the conclusion that all these little factors, like the construction techniques, the interconnectivity, the circular plan forms, orientation, the architectural features, all of this. So the conclusion that I had drawn from the thermometer study that I had done, the dry bulb and the wet bulb, was as follows. The overall warm and humid climate in Kerala is such that there is not much variation in the range of temperature.
And as it is a proven fact that lesser the difference between the dry bulb and the wet bulb temperature, more is the humidity, there is nothing much that can be done to reduce the humidity content. But in order to get a holistic comfort zone, one has to target in reducing the overall temperature of the build, which the Baker-style buildings have achieved to a substantial extent. And hence, although the humidity range is higher inside too, but with the fall in temperature and spatial design, which keeps the entire building well ventilated, one can barely feel the humidity inside as it is felt outside.